हेलो नमस्ते एवरीवन, दिस इज प्रोफेसर वेंकटरामु बीआर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इंग्लिश, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉलेजिएट एंड टेक्निकल एजुकेशन, वर्किंग एट गवर्नमेंट फर्स्ट ग्रेड कॉलेज गुडबंडे। फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस डिजिटल लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम, एन इनिशिएटिव ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ कर्नाटक। वेल, दिस इज द इंग्लिश क्लास फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीकॉम फोर्थ सेमेस्टर ऑफ बेंगलुरु नॉर्थ यूनिवर्सिटी एंड ऑल्सो फॉर बैंगलोर सिटी। वी हैव बीन लर्निंग अ लेसन टाइटल्ड एज हाउ कचा गॉट द सीक्रेट। इट इज बाय तंगम कृष्णन। Yeah, in this session, we are going to have discussion of the important thing that is called the narration and explanation of the lesson. In this session, I am going to narrate the entire lesson. Where and when it is required, I will also explain the lesson. And I have devised a method to explain this one. That is called as dividing the text into smaller units. The entire text I have divided different smaller units, and I will explain one by one in the order that is there in the text. Yeah, now let's come to the first and foremost unit that I am going to discuss. As soon as we open the lesson, we come to know that there is an introduction, the opening event in the story, that is about a strange thing, something is happening. The strange thing is that it's a war. The war was taking place between the gods and demons. Yeah, let us come to this beginning. Friends, I told you that how Kacha got the secret is a mythological story. This is the story about the churning of the ocean of milk. It is also called as Samudra Manthan. Maybe in the Samudra Manthan, the gods and demons were expecting some great thing. That was a kind of elixir. It is also called as Amrut. For the sake of possessing this Amrut or elixir, the gods and demons had a tussle. This tussle resulted ultimately in the war. The war between the gods and demons, which resulted in the severe casualties, in which gods perished in dozens and the demons perished in hundreds. But suddenly the calculation changed. The number of gods was decreasing and the number of demons were increasing. Kacha, the handsome son of Brihaspati, came to his father and asked his father about the difference. Brihaspati answered that the learned guru of the demons, Shukracharya, was making use of his Sanjivini mantra and reviving all the demons. But unfortunately, Brihaspati did not know the Sanjivini mantra. In the second unit of this lesson, we are going to discuss how does one win a game. It can also be titled as Kacha's oath to remain unmarried until his mission is fulfilled. Let us discuss this second event, or second incident, or unit of this lesson. Friends, I told you that there was a severe war. As a result, the gods were very much frustrated and demoralized. In spite of that, they continued as if it had become a question of survival. One day, Kacha said that he would go to Shukra and become his student. After Shukra teaches the Sanjivini mantra, he will come back. But the gods refused the proposal in unison. They said that he is too young and also the only son of Guru Brihaspati. If the demons came to know his identity, they would certainly kill him. Kacha then asked, "Tell me, how does one win a game?" Nobody answered. Nobody knew the answer. Kacha himself answered that by being in a game, and if one is in the game, one can also lose. Again, the gods discouraged the idea of going to Shukra, because Shukra has a beautiful daughter, the only daughter, Devayani. Kacha may forget all about gods when he sees this damsel. and may even fall in love with this beautiful girl. Kacha said, if that is all you are afraid of, let me assure you now and forever that I will never fall in love with this woman, however beautiful she may be. He waited for some time and then continued, in fact, I now take a vow to remain unmarried till my mission is fulfilled. Now let's come to the another unit, the third unit in this lesson. It is titled as Kacha went to Shukracharya and becomes his student. It was decided that Kacha, the only son of Guru Brihaspati, would go to the land of demons to learn the Sanjeevini mantra. Kacha went to Vishaparva, where Shukracharya had his ashram or hermitage. He introduced himself to the great priest and said respectfully that he is the grandson of Maharshi Anjira and the son of Brihaspati, the priest of gods. He implored Shukra to accept him as his pupil. He also promised to live the celibate life of Brahmachari. Shukracharya, with the humility of Kacha, accepted him as his pupil. He assured him that he will treat him as if he is treating his friend Brihaspati, and he would honor him to accept Kacha as his pupil. Shukra taught him many things in the years that Kacha stayed with him. One thing he did not teach, however, was Sanjeevini mantra. Kacha started his studentship and would keep the guru happy with his behavior. He would also take care of the guru's daughter, Devayani. Time passed and Kacha became Shukracharya's favorite pupil. Friends, now let us move on to the next unit of discussion, that is titled as Kacha continued to serve his teacher and also his daughter Devayani. Yeah, friends, Shukra taught Kacha many things in the years Kacha stayed with him. The one thing that he did not teach, however, was Sanjeevini mantra. Kacha was very patient. He continued to serve his master and also his beautiful daughter Devayani. Devayani was a lively young girl of beauty that was rare and delicate. Devayani was the apple of Shukracharya's eye, and Shukracharya did everything in his power to make his darling daughter very happy. She did not refuse her anything. Kacha was also in total attendance where Devayani was concerned. They were good friends. Kacha told her many stories of valor, of the battle between gods and demons. He regaled her with jokes, and her laughter reverberated among the trees of the beautiful garden, making the leaves quiver in silent laughter, while the branches swayed in a loud guffaw as they shared with her mirth. Kacha played with Devayani while she ran to hide in a game of hide and seek. Despite his closeness with Devayani, Kacha never forgot his oath even for a moment. No, not even when Devayani expressed her love for him one day. Now let's move to the next unit of this lesson, that is called as Devayani expressed her love for Kacha. How does she express her love? Let us see here. Devayani became very close to Kacha and she expressed her love. Kacha, despite his closeness with Devayani, he never forget his oath, even for a moment. Not even when Devayani expressed her love for him one day. Kacha said firmly that it could never be so, because he has taken this oath for an important cause and nothing on earth will make his change his mind. Friends, let us move on to another unit of this lesson. This smaller unit is going to give the beginning step where Kacha is going to face the tragedies from here onwards. The first and foremost tragedy that he faces is from the demon side. I have given this unit, a small unit in this lesson, as the demons had killed Kacha and thrown him over the mountains. This is the title I have given here. How did they identify him? How did they kill him? These things we shall see in this part of discussion. Friends, one day the demons spotted Kacha with Devayani. The demons recognized him to be Brihaspati's son. They were angry and waited for a chance to kill him. They felt he must have learned all the secrets about demons. Since they could not directly accuse their teacher, they waited for an opportunity to catch hold of him and kill him when he was alone. The opportunity came the next day when Kacha took the cattle for grazing. While Kacha was going up along the mountain path, the demons came behind him and threw him into the air. He fell deep down the mountain and died. When the cattle returned in the evening without Kacha, Devayani got anxious. Devayani was very anxious that the cattle had returned alone. Shukra assured her that Kacha must be on his way and he would be back soon. But Kacha did not come back. But the dirty demons had killed Devayani started crying. She pleaded with her father, sobbed and felt she wanted Kacha. Seeing his daughter's agony, Shukra uttered the Sanjeevini mantra and soon Kacha walked in. Shukra asked what happened to him, where he was all the time. Kacha replied that the demons had killed him and thrown him over the mountains. Move on to the next smaller unit of this lesson. I have titled this unit as the second attempt of the demons to kill Kacha. Or it can also be titled as Kacha was flung far off into the sea. Let us go to the text. After a few weeks, the demons spotted Kacha again. They gnashed their teeth. They felt that their master must have revived him with his mantra. However, they have to get rid of him. The next day, while Kacha was alone, they carried him away and flung him farther into the sea. They clapped their hands when Kacha was drowned and died. Devayani waited for him, Kacha, as earlier she was waiting. As he did not come home, Devayani started crying again. She would not touch her food. No amount of consoling her father could help her. Her father asked, "What can they do? Perhaps his time to die has come. After all, everyone has to die sometime or the other." She pleaded with her father that he must revive Kacha. Shukra could not refuse the plea of his daughter and uttered once again the Sanjeevini mantra. Soon Kacha came home. Devayani, jumping with joy, ran to him. When she asked him with concern what happened again, Kacha explained the whole incident to her and added that at the end, he was sure the next time they would try to destroy him by fire, as they had already tried with water and air. He then said jokingly, then his ashes would fly away and he would be gone forever. Friends, after all these two episodes or two deaths of Kacha, now it's a third death. This death is very strange. Let us see how he dies. Kacha was in a pensive mood these days. It had been a long time since he had promised the Sanjeevini mantra to the gods, and still he had not had any success. what did he say to the gods before leaving? You have to be in the game to win. That's what he said. Then the idea struck him. He had walked quite a distance from his house while in deep thought, and was brought back to the reality when the demons caught him. They said that time they are going to throw him into the fire. Kacha warned them that Shukra would bring him back. The demons agreed and asked them what they were to do. Kacha admitted that he is also fed up with dying every day and would now like to die forever. He advised them that after burning him, they should put his ashes inside the teacher. He told him if he came out alive, Shukra would die too. Hence, he will never revive him again. The demons agreed, and they said that they would feed his ashes to his master so that he never comes alive again. Later, they threw Kacha into the fire, and when he was burnt, took his ashes and, unknown to Shukra, mixed the ashes in his wine. Kacha soon landed in his master's stomach. Friends, now let us move on to another unit of discussion. This smaller unit of discussion, I call it as Shukracharya's O. Let us discuss the contents related to this unit. Devayani desperately searched for her dear Kacha. She cried uncontrollably and said that the demons had killed him again. She pleaded with her father to do something to revive Kacha. This time, Shukra was very much annoyed and angry. He quickly uttered the magical words of Sanjeevini Mantra, but Kacha did not come out this time. He uttered the mantra for the second time and for the third time. It is of useless. Still, there was no Kacha, and Shukra and Devayani were worried. Shukra wondered where was Kacha. Kacha answered that he is inside his teacher Shukracharya, but he cannot come out until he says so. He further says that he does not want to harm him. Kacha said that the demons had burnt him and mixed the ashes in Shukracharya's drink. Shukra was very much annoyed. He said that he would never forgive them for this ghastly mistake. He then added, from that day onwards, vows never to take wine. Now let's move on to the last smaller unit of this lesson. Have given the title Kacha's Mission Accomplished. Yeah, now let's come to the discussion of this unit. Devayani asked her father to bring back Kacha at any cost. Shukra is irritated and asked whether she wanted her father or Kacha. Shukracharya also informed her, if Kacha comes out, Shukra will die. Devayani replied that she wanted both of them, as she cannot leave even if one of them dies. Shukra says that then there is only one way out. He has to teach the Sanjeevini Mantra to Kacha. Once he comes out and Shukracharya is killed, then he can utter it and revive Shukra. Then Shukra taught Kacha the Sanjeevini Mantra. He also made him repeat it several times. Finally, he ordered Kacha to come out. When Kacha came out, causing the death of Shukra in the process, he kept his words to the teacher. He said the magical words of Sanjeevini Mantra and Shukra came back to life. Now, both of them were alive. After a few days, with his mission accomplished, Kacha took leave of his teacher and also a reluctant Devayani. He returned to gods. He gave them the secret he had learned. That's all the lesson. I'm sure you have enjoyed this lesson. And watch one more video so that I will upload soon regarding this chapter. Thank you very much. Friends, thank you very much for watching this video till the end. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. And also do subscribe to this channel if you haven't subscribed till now.